A.J. Allmendinger, Brad Keselowski. I mean, what a group that he is joining as a winner in this 22 car. Coming through turn number four. Another first-time winner in the Nationwide Series at Kentucky. It's Ryan Blaney.
Got one more lap to finish it up, buddy.
That's all right. White flag, white flag. Everybody on their feet here at Charlotte Motor Speedway. And the fifth chase in the race for the Sprint Cup is green.
Remember, we heard a while back Brian Vickers was really happy with his race car, but he has just slipped back at the expense of Dale Earnhardt Jr.
Kurt's into the wall. Boyer's in it as well. And Kurt's getting the worst of it. Oh man, from the back, Elliott Sadler. And look at this engine out of this thing.
And the race off pit road as everybody holds station in the top three. Austin Dillon picks up two. Brian Vickers picks up four.
On the pace laps, we have a total of 12 onboard cameras. And let's show you.
He passes the 12 here, but then. All right, let's talk to the driver of that 32 car. How about it, Jamie Little?
Series regular winning this year. Carl down on the apron.
Looks like Allgaier's
out of fuel. Who's going to coast to the finish line? Trevor Bayne. Here they come. It's going to be a drag race to the finish. Could Trevor Bayne do it? Did he get his first win?
Here's from his onboard.
Over to the stripe. Who's going to lead? Lap number four. Officially, Clint Boyer.
Let's check in on our 8 onboard cameras. You already know that Brian Scott's got the Nationwide Insurance onboard as our in-race reporter. Austin Dillon with the Advocare onboard.
The Memphis brought to you by Crown Royal Blended Canadian Whiskey. Not about quality. It's about quality, not quantity.
How big do you think the butterflies are in Blaney's stomach right now?
They honestly don't exist.
So the engines come to life on the 43 cars out of the 49 that have made the field.
He was already loose, though. We've seen the lap two before that. He was really struggling for a grip.
Watch Carl Larson here.
Sam, the only car in the top five in points that has not had an issue at all today. And that's the closest he's come, really, that contact with the Packers.
As an example of some give and take, and you know, you've got to applaud the drivers there.
Look at this as Pappas literally gets pulled out of the way by Andrew Ranger.
At the field, you heard about Joey Logano and his clutch issue, he'll be at the back. So will Eric McClure and Mike Bliss for unapproved changes. And Kenny Wallace's time was disallowed, they were too low in post race inspection.
In one lap,
yes, amazing what you can do. You close your eyes and break a little bit.
Coming right by, Hamlin says, what went past me right there? Good, Kevin Harvick. This would be a popular win in the garage area as well. There's your top five. The only driver to lead every lap in his first win was Dale Jarrett. Gonna be all night long, took a total of 16 seconds. Joey Logano leads.
Well, that's a fun evening.
Yeah, I always love the home run.
Yeah, good batsman. They can kill it.
Man, I can't get it past second base.
Out on the track. Is Ricky Stenhouse. So the pair of Fords in front of them. Ricky Mayhew in his debut in the Nationwide Series there. Now there is Austin Dillon as he is, you see, the only thing missing is a win this year as he leads in all those characters.
in the categories. Here comes Austin Dillon in that three car, looking to go underneath the 54, and he clears it.
On the left side of your screen, as we now zero in on Logano.
Right.
Oh, right front. Looking like it's needing some more of that oxygen.
Or nitrogen.
Or, yeah. Give me air, please.
Checking the calendar, we've got drag racing for you. The O'Reilly Auto Parts NHRA Northwest Nationals qualifying at 10 Eastern tonight over on ESPN2. Of course, tomorrow a full... Excuse me, we got Sprint Cup Series at Pocono. Excuse me, we've got... Ricky, take this for me, please.
And then opening up a half-second lead that he never surrendered, doing the black flip for the second... And the only problem is it's not 8 seconds according to the scoring monitor. It's about 4.5. But still, enough.
Well, he's looking back to the next point car. They're really in this championship.
That's true.
Hunt.
You're right.
He's looking at cars that are going
to. Because you're right. That's Casey Kane. That is the next car back 4.5 seconds. And then it's further back to Brian Scott. So you're absolutely right, Andy.
A chance of rain. It has arrived here as we have completed 226 of 400 races.
Well, here we go. Remember Trevor Bayne? His car was set up for the long run back in June. And we've had long green runs. This one is like 75 laps.
Richmond next week, on to Chicago, Dover, Kansas, right on through to the season ender, November 19th at Homestead Miami Speedway. And it's NASCAR.
Austin Dillon, 4.6 seconds. He is just marching through this field again. He had the fastest race lap the last two consecutive laps. Here he comes across the line again. There is the gap back to Regan Smith.
Hello again, everybody. Marty Reid alongside winning Brickyard driver Dale Jarrett. Winning Brickyard crew chief. I know who you are, and Nick, it's great to see you. It's great to be back with you guys again. We've had so much fun all weekend long.
It's Kyle Busch, Brian Vickers, and then Austin Dillon. It's going to be Kyle Busch picking up win number 4. Somehow they got enough fuel in the tank, and they made it. I'm sorry, final lap. One more lap to go. I got so excited, I got one lap ahead of myself.
Casey. Ryan Gifford making his nationwide debut. Look at this, right now, Gifford is running in the top 15, 15th position. He's fourth in the East Point Series.
Mornish Jr., our pole sitter, surrendered it to his teammate, the 22 of Brad Keselowski. Third place is Carl Edwards Jr. Mornish, Logano, Keselowski, Allgaier, and Regan Smith running in the fifth position right now. Going down the backstretch, which really isn't a backstretch. There's a pretty big curve there.
It's not a back straightaway, it's a back stretch.
Yeah.
It's got a little curve to it.
I think there was a lot of concern, some apprehension by drivers, and Kyle's like, I love this place. Attitude matters.
Right alongside is Nelson Piquet in the 30 car.
Well, it is time as we get ready to go down trackside for the opening series. The opening ceremonies for the inaugural nationwide event.
Yeah, regardless of how he made it look, there's no easy way through them.
Vickers gets through as well. That's three of our top five in the championship.
There's Danica Patrick out in front now of Ron Fellows. Then Jacques Villeneuve in the 22. Ron Hornish fourth.
This sixth caution continues here at Mid-Ohio Sports Car Cars. We've had coming out in turn number 4 with his sixth win of the win and the first repeat winner at New Hampshire.
There it is. Just one
white
more
flag.
Circuit.
He won. Good lap.
Nothing any of these guys can do. That hammering you hear is the sound of the nail of the final coffin on the chase contender's hopes of upset.
It's amazing what you can do. You close your eyes and break for a little bit.
Canadian whiskey. Not about quality. It's about quality, not quantity.
On the left side of your screen, as we now zero in on Logano.
I'm Marty Reid. Thanks so much for joining us. Till we meet again.